Okay, Assalamualaikum and good afternoon to everyone. So for this week, I'm just doing a recording lecture because I have something to do this evening. So I hope that you can listen to my lecture, okay, and then do a necessary instructions, okay, per given. Alright, let me start. Okay, so this week we are going to continue with the resume, how to prepare a resume. Okay, how to enlarge this? Okay, prepare high impact resume. Okay, as we know that under this topic, you are going to write a assignment, okay, assignment for resume. So it consists of 15% from your total PB. So under this topic, we are going to focus on how to identify the characteristic of a high impact resume. And second point is how to integrate the relevant qualifications, experiences, skills, and personal information using an appropriate resume format and language. Okay, who? Okay, I have to ask you questions since this is a recording. Okay, let me explain what is resume. Resume or resume is a concise document, typically not longer than any page, one page, as the intended reader will not dwell on your document for very long. The goal of a resume is to make an individual stand out from the competition. So basically, from the resume itself, your own resume can stand you out, okay, compared from the others. If you have a very impactful resume which get their attention, so definitely they are going to choose you. Okay, high impact resume. What is the difference between resume and high impact resume? Okay, resume also we call as CV. CV meaning that curriculum vitae. Okay, high impact resume meaning that they are creating a high impact CV about using the correct blend of structure, format, and content to quickly show readers that you are the perfect fit for the job. If your CV instantly tells recruiters that you have the skills and experience that they are looking for, then they will be queuing up to interview you. So we did that. Every company will trying to get you into their company. You don't have to actually looking for the company, tapi company itu sendiri yang akan cari you. Okay, resume and curriculum vitae. What is the difference? So for resume, showcase the competence, work history, accomplishment, etc. Okay, depends on type of resume that you are going to read to write. Okay, and it used for practically any job and typically concise for one page only, but for curriculum vitae, it shows credentials, certification, research, affiliations, etc. So they are actually focused more on your achievement, okay, your certification, your award, something like that. And then it's usually used for academic such as the lecturer or maybe the doctorate, scientific or medical jobs, okay, and it's typically detailed, which they have several pages long. Okay, this one is focused more on the professional career. Okay, so for you have to create a resume because you want to showcase your skills, your competency. Okay, and all right, so that's four. In the summary, CV meaning is something which is long, covers your entire career and static. Which is but apa ni? Meanwhile, resume they are short, no particular format rule. Memang tak ada format langsung. Depends on you how you want to create your resume, and highly cost customizable. Maksudnya you boleh adjust according to your creativity. Okay, we have three types of resume. Number one is chronological, functional, and hybrid. Okay, so basically, chronological resume, they best for those who work history is very closely related to the desired job. For example, like Macam I kan, contohlah kalau I kerja dekat dalam private sector kan, I'm working as a lecturer and I apply for to teach at college for example, apa eh, college yang famous sikit, apa tu nama dia, lupa lah pula, tak kisahlah, okay, private college. So my resume akan shows my experience from the start until the end, okay, from the beginning until the recent yang terkini. So we focus more on the job experience, okay. Meanwhile for the functional is something the resume that those who want to highlight their skills and people who are seeking a career change. Maksudnya dia nak ubah kerjaya ataupun dia, you macam you kan, fresh graduate nak start apply kerja, so you kena buat functional lah sebab kita nak explainkan secara brief tentang semuanya. And the hybrid dia mix, okay, dia mix antara dua tu. Okay, what is chronological resume? Macam tadi I mentioned, chronological resume is one of the three main resume formats. This format draws attention to your work experience. Your current job or most recent position is listed first and it continues in reverse. Chronological order through the rest of your work history. Okay, so basically it's a, we can see the timeline of your work experience. Okay, this is the sample, which is the focus on the experience that they had. Okay, when you see that, the first one is the position, bukan position, the place. The place of dia punya kerja kat mana. And then second, data network manager tu adalah position dia. And then dia ada years dia. So, dia bekerja dari tahun bila ke tahun bila. And then they list down the job scope. Okay, apa yang dia buat, and then the achievement. Achievement dia, apa yang dia pernah buat. And then remember that untuk chronological resume ni, they are more attract with the number. Dia suka tengok number. So, dia akan nampak. Macam ni kan, dia nampak lah nama-nama ni. So, numbering. Okay, so dia akan nampak achievement kita. Okay, functional resume, it focuses on your skills and experience rather than your chronological work history. It is typically used by job seekers who are changing careers. Changing careers maksudnya sebelum ni maybe you jadi storekeeper and then you nak cuba buat marketing. Okay, so dia, you kena buat lah functional resume. It is typically used by job seeker who are changing career, who have gaps in their employment history or whose work history is not related directly to the job. Okay, in this way, specific skills and capabilities are emphasized to highlight the job seeker's ability. So we focus more on your capabilities and we highlight on your abilities and skills. Okay. Okay, this is the example which they have applicants detail. Okay, and then they have the skills and then the person professional accomplishment. Recommended type resume for fresh graduate is the hybrid resume. Okay, so what should we include in your resume? Hybrid ni sebabkan because you tak ada work experience sangat. Okay, sebab tu kita boleh suruh you buat hybrid resume. What should be included in your resume? First, passport size photo. The passport size photo should apa ni? Bukan gambar selfie, bukan gambar you pakai macam gambar posing depan KLCC. Okay, so make sure passport size photo yang background dia adalah plain colour. And then make sure kalau girls mesti kena pakai makeup-makeup sikit supaya muka you nampak lebih berseri. And then tudung jangan terlalu bunga-bunga yang attract attention, satin ke apa benda, go plain. Okay, plain yang dark colour, tak silap saya, dark colour. Okay, kalau yang lelaki, make sure pakai apa ni? Pakai kemeja ataupun pakai collar shirt. Okay, depends on your kerja lah. Contohnya, you nak kerja sebagai maintenance. Takkanlah you nak ambil ambil gambar pakai coat kan? So, coat tu kan sesuai untuk orang yang kerja office. Okay, so pakailah baju bercollar. Okay, and then you should also include the position applied in your resume. Okay, kena letak, nak letak, nak minta position apa. And then objective, what is the objective profile tau, objective profile apa. Objektif ni umpamanya apa yang you nak sebenarnya dengan career you. Okay, sama ada lebih kepada diri you ataupun lebih kepada apa yang you cari dalam company tu. Okay, jadi kita akan tengok cara kita nak cara nak buat objektif ni. And then we have personal details. Personal details ni very simple. You tak payah masukkan yang sampai nombor gaji, nombor KWSP lah, berat lah apa dia. Dia cuma perlukan nama penuh, email address, contact number and you punya address. Itu je pun enough. Okay, sebab it's easier for them to looking for you lah. Okay, education and qualifications, kita akan highlightkan yang top 3 lah. Okay, tak payahlah sampai you PSR, tak payah. Okay, contohnya SPM ataupun SCPM, diploma je tu. Experience, kalau you ada experience, tulislah. And then bawa experience tu, you kena brief sikit. Apa, what are your job scope? Apa yang you buat masa tu? Skills, strengths and abilities, as I mentioned from our first week of this topic, what is your skills, what is your strengths and what are your abilities. So you kena tulis kat situ and then kita boleh masukkan dalam bentuk grafik. Okay, extracurricular activities, this is optional. Kalau you are a very active person, you can just write down. Okay, achievement, apa you punya best achievement, for example like a dean list ke kan. Okay, so boleh ambil references meaning that a person who are not your family members tapi the company can contact the person to ask for you. Okay, usually we have we give two names. Okay, objective, for example like this: a young and dynamic graduate who has good technical skills, communication skills and learning to learn attitude to contribute. Mesti you kena ada tulis apa benda to contribute, apa yang you boleh sumbangkan to the company. Okay, two or three lines to describe your intensity and capability in winning the job. Okay, maksudnya kat sini you highlightkan you punya apa, contohnya macam I, contohlah I cakap a competent lecturer who good in technology, macam tu lah. Okay, good communication skills and student centered benda lah lebih kurang kan. Okay, so orang akan lebih berminat apa yang you ada tu untuk dioferkan kepada company. How to write an objective for a resume? Number one, keep it short. Don't add bluff. Okay, maksudnya jangan merepek bukan-bukan lah. Okay, lepas tu, be clear and detailed about the job you want. State the position you are applying for and describe your goals only as they pertain to the job and industry for which you are applying. Maksudnya, you kena clear and detail. Okay, explain what you can do for them. Apa yang you boleh buat untuk mereka, to the successful of the company, to the revenue ke, atau towards to achieve the company's goal. Okay, macam tu pun boleh juga. Okay, personal details, only important details. Okay, IC, name, contact number or email and address, that is enough. Okay, kalau you nak tulis marital status, married or single, tu tak payah. Okay, sebab dia orang boleh age, dia orang boleh tengok from your IC. Education and qualification, basically we post or kalau boleh kita tulis dalam bentuk reverse lagi. Recent, yang paling recent punya education tu top, paling atas sekali. Kita nak tengok highest qualification you ke atas sekali. Okay, you can write down your apa tu namanya, dia lah diploma in petrochemical engineering, apa yang kita nak cakap tu, you punya qualification lah. Okay, sijil you dalam bidang apa, and then tahun you belajar daripada tahun bila sampai tahun bila, and then kat mana tempat dia, politeknik tu Said Nasir. So what your outstanding achievement, okay, during your study. So you boleh masukkan lah. Okay. Yang berkaitan. Contohnya ni kan, attended academic courses in OSHA application for heavy machineries in petroleum industry and green technology. Okay. Mungkin experience, okay, maybe akan cakap, kita akan tulis lah macam ni untuk internship kan. So, dalam in bracket, you kena tulis internship. So, you need to write down the work details or job specifications. Skills, strengths and abilities. Conversant in Malay, Mandarin, Arabic language. Okay, which is we call as language proficiency. Okay, sound knowledge in CAD or CM and CNC computer control. This is we call as computer skills. Certified training in OSHA. Okay, that one is other skill. Kalau you tak tahu nak letak apa kan, dia akan jadi other skills. Extracurricular, ni lah. You kena statekan dari tahun bila, tahun sampai bila, and then apa nama position tu dan apa yang you buat. Achievement, you punya pencapaian. Macam ni lah. Then references, mesti at least two professional referees. You boleh ambil you punya PA ataupun you punya, nanti kan you buat training kan, industrial training tu, siapa you punya supervisor tu. Okay, you should include their name and then their position and their company's punya detail and contact number and email. Okay. Okay, this is what we call using the full block format. Full block tu maksudnya, dia macam ni lah keadaan dia. Okay. Errors in resume. Identify all the errors in the sentences and phrases below. This is macam latihan. Eh? Okay, kat sini kalau you tengok, my responsible at the job at the company included. So, ayat dia tak berapa cantik. So, satu tak berapa cantik. Lepas tu, dia macam ni, macam yang saya kena ni, manage monthly operation budget and design the cover for our company's magazine. Kenapa mesti ada ni? Kenapa mesti ada slash tu? So, take care of your punctuation semua. Okay, extracurricular activity. Kenapa E ni huruf kecil? Okay. Perak. Perak huruf besar patutnya. Okay, represent the Perak state. MSSP, Majlis Sukan-Sukan Perak. Kena huruf besar. Okay, career objective dia. Yang ni kita tengok lah error. Marketing position using previous experience or promoting consumer product and well develop personal skills. Okay, tak ada full stop. Lepas tu dia punya using previous experience on promoting. So, dia cuma, yang ni kalau I boleh cakap dia malas lah. Malas nak tulis career objective dia. Okay. SPM obtain decision in mathematics and statistics. Apa benda? Listkan lah. Alright, strength. Error, spelling error. Okay, strength. So, make sure you check betul-betul your resume. Okay. Alright. Sekejap Okay. That is for the first lecture. Okay. You boleh dengar dulu nanti. We will continue with the second. Alright. Wait ya. Bye-bye.